Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to everyone in Chembooster with Dia Shehzadi. I welcome to all of you with the new topic of the second chapter, that is basically the last topic of our second chapter, applications of the isotopes as well as the uses of the isotopes in the different fields of the life. Applications of the isotopes. Okay. We are just learning about the sciences and the isotopic forms of the anything that are used in the various fields, in the technological fields of the isotopes. The applications are the vast application. The biggest application is in the field of the medicine, as the medicine is the just the curing or the diagnosing of the any disease, and the for the radiotherapy, that is a treatment for using for the treatment of the diseases, and the treatment of the different diseases are the harmful diseases that were incurable for the last era, but since they are the curable, and the different diseases like including the cancer, this is the major or the biggest disease that was incurable, but it's now curable, and its treatment is just because of the isotopes. We are using the different type of the isotopes for treating the cancers. Uses as well as the applications are the vast, its uses are also vast. The field of the science is a major field where the isotopes are used for the scientifically. They were firstly experienced in the lab, then they are applicable for the curing the diseases in the applicable or in the practical diseases. Okay, in the different fields, here we are talking about the just five fields in where we are using the isotopes for the curing or the for the different treatment of the diseases or the for the relating to the medical field. Firstly, the radiotherapy, that is a major or the basically light curing process or the requiring treatment that is used for the cancer. The treatment and the tracer for the diagnosing and the medicine. For the tracer is a light amount or the minute amount of anything for the diagnosing, how to recognize what is this and to curable, and the medicine is according to the field of the medicine. And archaeological and geological uses. Archaeological, its meaning for the archaeology, and the geology is for the relating to the earth field. And the chemical reaction and the structures determination, what are the chemical structures and the structures and the chemical reactions and the determination of the structures, how they are looking, they are crystal or non-pure or MFR structures and the different structures, and the applications in the power generation to produce the electricity. These are the applications of the uses of the isotopes we are using. Let's move towards their detailed information. Radiotherapy. As we know, the word radio is a therapy, is a treatment. Therapy is basically relating or discovering from the therapy is a treatment. To treatment to cure anything, and radio is the using of the lightweight radiations. These are the beta radiations and the gamma radiations that are less harmful than the alpha radiations. For the treatment of the skin cancer, we are using for the beta phosphorus 32 and the strontium 90 were using for the treatment of the skin care, because they are the less penetrating beta radiations. They penetrate into the skin and treat or the focus or the at the position where the cancerous cell or the carcinogen cells are present to knock out these cells from the skin and to cure the skin from the cancer. These are the light penetrating and the light emitting radiations, that are the beta radiations. And for the treatment of the cancer, the beta radiations that are the gamma radiations, that is the cobalt 16. Cobalt is an isotope, and the element that cobalt 60 is an isotope of the cobalt 60. So we are using the cobalt 60 is an isotope of the cobalt for the penetrating within the body. These are the strongly penetrating radiation that are using for the treatment of the high radiating cure of the cancer. These are the gamma rays, and they will collectively to emit that portion to focus that where the gamma rays are the where the cancer cell are the present, the gamma rays will focus on them and to penetrate or to discover or to extract the gamma rays, and the cancerous cell will be killed from there. Trace for the diagnosis and the medicine. In the field of the radioactive isotopes are used for the traces in the medicine to diagnose, to process the tumor in the body. The tumor is a portion where the cells are collected, and they will cause the disease, that is a tumor. tumor. Isotope of the iodine 131 are used for diagnosing of the goiter in the thyroid glands. The thyroid gland is an organ that of the body, and the goiter is the disease, and the isotope that is using for the diagnostic and treating this is the iodine 131. And in the titanium is used for the monitoring of the bone growth. Where is the bone growth, how it's properly growing or not, we will use the titanium is a technique that is used for the monitoring of the bone growth. The third, archaeology and geological uses. These are the archaeological, basically we know the fossils. We know the rocks, fossils, what are the raw materials that behinding the, these are the discoveries for the any presence of the anybody that was from the existing from the different areas and from the different eras. The radioactive isotopes are used to estimate the age of the fossils, like the dead plants or the animals or the stones. If a plant that is 100 years ago and they were planted in the earth, but now they are not present in the earth, then the fossils of the remaining of these dead plants will be the main evidence of this, that the these plants were existing in the last years, but now they are not, they are extinctable. So these are the fossils of those plants. The age determination is a very of the very old object, the based on the half-lives. Half-life is a process that is used to determine the time life or the to speed where when the if we are taking the carbon atom, carbon half-life is a 2.5 years. Oh, okay, 1.5 years, 1.25 is the half of the 5, 1.25 years. When they will be completed, then the carbon atom will be, or the fossils of the carbon will be remain half. Half will be decayed and half will be remain. And these are the basically a major use of these isotopes that were using the half-life, and they are called the radioactive isotope dating. These are the dating means to present or to discover or to calculate the exact date of their existence. The importance method of the age determining is the cold carbon containing the object fossils by measuring the radioactivity of the carbon 14 in them, called the radiocarbon dating and the simple carbon dating. This the carbon is the, we are taking this as a radiant or a simply a sample or a template for the determining the others relating others the carbon atom or the isotopes for the half-life. Yeah. Chemical reaction and the structures determination. It's a major and the most important that the radioactive isotopes are used to in a chemical reaction to follow out the radioactive element during the reaction and ultimate to determine the day and structure. What is the structure, and they are just processing the structures or the chemical reaction, how it's explaining and how it's occurring, and the products that are formed by this and what is the structure of that product. For example, the carbon 14 is used to label the carbon dioxide. A carbon dioxide is used by the plants for the photosynthesis. We know the process of the photosynthesis. The plant leaves will absorb the carbon dioxide from the outer side, and they will occupy also the absorb the oxygen and the water from the bottom. Water is treating evaporating, and the sun is producing the light, and in this stage they will produce the glucose that is a major source of the energy for the plants, and the movement during the reaction is determined through the various intermediate steps up to the glucose. For the formation of the glucose at the end product with the always this will be the glucose, and to how the oxygen, carbon dioxide and the carbon will converted into the carbon dioxide when the oxygen is combined with the carbon, and this will be formed the carbon dioxide, and this will be also reacted, further reacted with the water molecules, and this will be produces to the glucose, that is C6H6O12, sorry, O11, that is the formula of the glucose. And also the radioactive isotopes, that is the carbon 14, this is also using for the determination of the structure of the glucose, whether it is a 6 carbon or the 5 carbon or a deoxyribonucleic acid or the ribonucleic acid. Okay, in the last field, that is the major field in the for the isotope uses in the power generation. How isotopes are used in the power generation? Radioactive isotopes that are the light emitting Radioactive means they are the chemically reactive. They want to react with others to produce something new. The radioactive isotopes are used to generate the electricity by carrying out the controlled nuclear fission reaction in a nuclear reactor. Nuclear reactor is a chamber where the nuclear fission reaction will take place, and the electricity will produce from this. The radioactive isotopes will react with the neutrons or in a controlled manner in a nuclear fission reactor. For example, we are taking the uranium-235, and this will bombard with the slow-moving neutrons. These are the neutrons that are the slow-moving neutrons. And these neutrons will break down the uranium nucleus and produce the barium and the krypton, that is the 94 and the 3 neutrons atom, and the huge amount of the energy. This is the basically the nuclear fusion reaction. This is the breakdown reaction, and the fusion reaction will be the combustion reaction will be the burning process, and the fusion reaction will be the breaking process. When the uranium is fused, this will produce is bombarded by the nucleus, that is neutrons, that are the slow moving particles. They will break the nucleus of the uranium-235 and produce the barium-193 and the krypton, that is the 94. And the three atoms are the three atoms of the neutrons in this reaction. And firstly, this will using the single neutron but slow moving neutron, and will produce the more extra two electron neutrons in this reaction, as well as the huge amount of the energy. And how this energy will be used, let's move to see this. Okay, the large amount of the energy that was produced by this fusion reaction in a power generation, this will be used in a power generation to convert the water in steam in boilers. The boiler is a chamber where the steam is produces to convert the water. Water is taking, and the steam is a high temperature flame. They will be introduced into the water, and the water will be converted into the steam. The water will evaporate, and the steam is then used to derive the turbines to generate the electricity. And this is a peaceful use of the atomic energy for the development of the nation, because this is a low cost process where we are just using the water molecules, and the steam is produces and providing to them. The water is converted into the vapors, that these vapors will be force the turbines to move and to drive the turbines to generate the electricity. And this is the most powerful part for the developing countries, for the using the developing countries. And the Pakistan is also using this for the generation of the electricity for our country. Okay, the last activity we also perform in every lecture, test yourself. How the goiter is in the thyroid gland is detected. We will use the iodine-131 for the detecting of the goiter in the thyroid gland. And the fusion reaction, what is the nuclear fusion reaction? When the any radioactive element or the radioactive isotope will react with a slow moving neutron to produce the different elements and plus the huge amount of the energy. This will be equal to the nuclear fission reaction. And when the uranium-235 break up, it produces a large amount of the energy. How this energy is used? In the previous slide, we will learn about this, that this energy will use to move the turbines to firstly to produce the water to steam, convert into the steam, and then steam will be moves the turbines to produce the electrical generator turbines and to produce the electricity. Uranium-235 fission reaction produces two atoms of, which are those atoms? First was the barium-193 and the krypton-94. These were the two atoms that were produced by the fission of the 235 fission reactions of the radioactive isotope. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Keep watching my videos and never forget to subscribe, like, share my videos with your friends. Take care of yourself and others. Allah Hafiz.